Hi, in this video, I am going to explain transportation problem. So before I am going to explain how to solve the transportation problem, let me explain introduction about transportation problem. Transportation problem means it is a special kind of linear programming problem in which goods are transported from a set of sources to set of destination subject to or according to supply and demand of the sources and destination respectively, such that the total cost of transportation is minimized. The ultimate objective of this particular technique is, in order to reduce the transportation cost, we need to apply some technique. So with the help of this, we can able to minimize or identify the method in order to avoid or minimize the transportation cost. So let me explain two different types of transportation problem. First one is balanced transportation problem. Balanced transportation problem means both supply and demand will be equal. Then it is called as balanced transportation problem. Unbalanced transportation problem means supply is not equal to demand. Unbalanced transportation problem. We cannot proceed with unbalanced transportation problem. To balance transportation problem, we need to add either dummy column or dummy row according to the situation. So there are two types, balanced as well as unbalanced transportation problem. Then methods of transportation problem. Generally, there are two phases for transportation problem. First one is finding the initial feasible solution. That is the first phase. First, we need to identify or find initial feasible solution. After finding this only, we can able to check the optimality. Which one is best? Optimum means best, maximum. And finding the best among the various alternatives. That is the second phases. So now I am going to explain with the example. So this is called as row. First row, second row, third row. These are the three sources are available. Okay. A, B, C, three columns. Each sources on each row, you will have some supply. In each column, you will have some demand. I told you, no, balanced transportation problem. Before you proceed, just see or confirm whether it is balanced transportation problem or unbalanced transportation problem. How can you find out this? Just compare the demand and supply. According to this problem, just see the demand. 200 plus 400 plus 400, 1000. Just see the supply. 200 plus 300, 500. Plus 500,000. It is a balanced transportation problem. With this problem, you can proceed. If it is unbalanced, means demand will not equal to supply. What will happen in that case? We need to add one more row or one more dummy column according to demand and supply. But anyway, if you want to continue the problem, you need to have balance. Balance means both demand and supply should be equal. Let us see the three different methods of three different techniques to find the initial basic feasible solution in phase 1. I told you, know, there are two methods of solving transportation problems. So first phase is finding the initial basic feasible solution. After finding this only, we can able to check optimality. So according to check the initial basic feasible, there are three methods are available. First one is northwest corner cell method, second one least cost cell method, and third one VAM method. Let me explain each and every one clearly. First one is northwest corner cell method. So this is a transportation problem. We'll have different sources and different destination. So according to this problem, there are three sources are available. Sources 1, 2 and 3, and 4 destinations are there. A, B, C, D. In each sources and each destination, some value is given. This is called as supply. For source 1, 300 supplies are available. Here 400 supplies are available, 500 supplies are available. For each destination, this is column, no? For each destination, we have some demand. For A, 250 demand is there. For B, 350. For C, 400. For D, 200. Before you solve this problem, first we need to check whether the problem is balanced or unbalanced. Balance means both demand and supply will be equal. Just check 250, 350, 400, 200. What is the total? 1200. Just check the supply. 300 plus 400 plus 500, 1200. So it is a balanced problem. Now you can proceed. So according to northwest corner cell method, you have to start with this corner. This is the northwest corner. So you have to start with this cell. Each and every element of this cell is considered as a cost per transportation. So first you have to start from this cell. This is the northwest corner. You have to start from here. Just allocate. Before you allocate the value, you have to compare demand for the particular column and supply for the particular row. Here supply 300 but demand is only 250. So which one is lesser value? Demand is lesser. So you have to allocate only demand, because demand is lesser than the supply. So based on the demand only we can able to supply. So 250 is lesser value. No, put 250 here. 250 is allocated, no? Just cancel, put 0. This row, 300 is there. We have allocated 250. 250 demand met. Remaining 50 supply is there. So this column, we got 0, no? So the entire row will be get cancelled. After deleting first column, the remaining cell is like this. Now we have to see which one is northwest corner. This is the northwest corner. Again, select this cell and see the demand and supply of respective cell. For this particular cell, demand 350, supply 50. Which one is lesser value? Supply is lesser than the demand. So allocate 50 rupees. 50 cancel, will get 0. For this, 350 is there, no? 50 match, remaining 300 demand is there. For this row, we got 0, no, the entire row will get cancelled. So after deleting the two thing, this is the remaining cell, remaining figure, unallocated cell. Out of the unallocated cell, find the northwest corner. Which one is northwest corner? This is the northwest corner cell. So start, allocate. For this column, 300 demand is there. For this row, 400 supply is there. Which one is less? Demand is lesser than supply. Put 300 here. Just cancel 0 because 300 is allocated. 400 supply is there. 300 is allocated. We'll have only 100 rupees. Here we got 0. No, just cancel this column. After deleting all these things, this is the remaining unallocated cell. With this unallocated cell, find the northwest corner. This is the northwest corner. So select this cell and allocate the value. So which one is less? Just compare the row value and column value. Column value is 400 for this cell and row value is 100. So which one is less? 100 is less. 100 is lesser value. Just write 100 here and you will get 0. And in out of 400, 0, no? Just cancel this. Now we have only two cells. This is the northwest corner, no? Allocate this cell. We have got 300 demand and 500 supply. Which one is lesser value? Demand is less. So put 300 here. Balance 200. Cancel 0. This also get cancelled. And finally, you will have only one cell unallocated. In this unallocated cell, you will have demand equal to supply. Just see. Demand also 200, supply also 200. It is a balanced problem. You won't get any balancing figure. Everything is cancelled. Now just multiply the value with the cell value. In first allocated cell, 250 into 3 plus 50 into 1 plus 300 into 6 plus 100 into 5 plus 300 into 3 plus 200 into 2. Just find the value. Total will be rupees 4400. Cost sell method. According to this method, first we need to find out least cost among the various costs. We have different sources and different destinations. No, in each cell we have got some value. So among the various value, first we need to identify which one is least. Just find out which one is least. This is the least value. So now I have selected this cell. Then we need to find out the supply and demand. Demand 350 for this particular cell and supply 300. So which one is lesser value? Supply is lesser than demand. So allocate 300 rupees. Get cancelled 0. 350 allocated, remaining 50 demand is there. This is 0, no? Just cancel the entire row. This is the remaining cell, unallocated cell. Among the unallocated cell, second step is find out the least cell. You can allocate any one cell because we have got same value in two different cells, no? We can allocate any one. I have selected this cell. Just find out the demand and supply of this particular cell. So what is the demand? 250 demand, 400 supply. Which one is less? Demand is lesser than supply. Just put 250 here. 250 get cancelled, 0. And here balance 150 is there. 0, no, just cancel this column. This is a remaining unallocated cell. Now find out which one is least cost among the 6 cells, unallocated cell. This is the least cost. Demand and supply. Demand 200 and supply 500. So which one is lesser value? Demand is lesser than supply. So I enter 200 here. 200 allocated will get 0. Here the balancing figure is 300. This is 0, no? Just cancel this column. Remaining unallocated cell is there, no? So among the unallocated cell, find out which one is least value. Here we have got 2, 3. So you can allocate any one. Just find or select this one, or you can select this also. Now I am selecting this one. And find the value. Demand 400, supply 300. So which one is lesser value? Supply is lesser than demand. So enter 300. Get cancelled. Balance 100. So this row 0, no? Just delete the entire row. Now we have only 2 cells. Which one is least value? 5 is least value. Select this cell and allocate the value. Just compare demand and supply. Demand 300 for this cell, supply 150. So 100 rupees is lesser than 150. So allocate 100, you will get 0. Here balancing figure 50. 0, no? Cancel this. And now we have only one unallocated cell and the balancing figure, that is demand, is equal to supply. Demand also 50, supply also 50. Just allocate 50. All supply and demand get cancelled. Now just multiply the value and find the answer. First one, 300 into 1. Second cell, this is the second cell, plus 250 into 2, plus 50 into 6, plus 100 into 5, plus 300 into 3, plus 200 into 2, 2900. Okay, let us see Ogle's approximation method. According to this method, before we solve the problem, first we need to find out row difference and column difference. For each and every row and for each and every column, we need to identify row difference and column difference. How can you find out the row difference? First, select the least cell in the first row. Which one is least value? 1 is the least value. Which one is the next least value? 3. Now find the difference between these two least value. 3, 2. In the same way, we need to identify row difference and column difference for each and every row as well as each and every column. In second row, 2 is the least value, next value 5. What is the difference between these two values? 3. In the third row, 2 is the least value. Next least value, 3. What is the difference between these two values? 1. Now, these are the row difference. In the same way, you need to identify column difference. In the first column, which is the least value? 2. Next, 3. What is the difference? 1. In the second column, 1, 3. Difference? 2. In the third column, 3, 5. Difference? 2. In the fourth column, 2 least value. Next, 4. What is the difference? 2. Now we have got row difference and column difference. The next step is select the maximum penalty. These are the values called as penalty. Row penalty, column penalty. Among these value, you have to find out or select maximum value. So which is the maximum value? 3 is the maximum value. 3 occurs in row 2. This value occurs in row 2. Find the cell with the least cost in row 2. This cell is the least value. Now I have selected this cell. Now you need to compare demand and supply of this particular cell. Demand 250, supply 400. Now you have to allocate the value. So which is the least value, 250 or 400? 250 is the least value. Just allocate 250 here and subtract this, you will get 0. Here you will get 150. So this row 0, no, cancel the entire column. Then after this, this is the rest of the cell, unallocated cell. Again you have to find out row difference and column difference with the unallocated cell. Again, in the first row, which one is the least value? 1. Next, 4. What is the difference between these two values? 3. In the second row, 5 is the least value. Next value, 6. Difference? 1. In the third row, 2 is the least value. Next, 3. Difference? 1. In the same way for column also. So first column is entire, column is deleted, no? Just put dash. In the second column, least value 1, next value 3, difference 2. Here also 2, here also 2. So among these value, find out the maximum value. 3 is the maximum value. Just select, this occurs in row 1. Again you have to find out the least cell in this first row. 1 is the least value. Just select this cell and enter either demand or supply, whichever is less. Demand 350, supply 300. Supply a lesser value. Just put 300 here. You will get 0. Here you will get 50 balance. So this row got 0, no? Just delete the entire row. Now one row, one column is over. Now we have only two rows and three columns are there. With this unallocated cell, again you have to find out row difference and column difference. In the first row, entire thing is over, no? Just put dash. In the second row, 5 is the least value. Next least value, 6. Difference, 1. Here also, 2, 3, 1. In the column, 3, 6. Difference, 3. 3, 5. Difference, 2. 2, 9. Difference, 7. Among these penalties, which one is the highest value? 7 is the maximum value. Just select this one. This occurs in last column, that is fourth column. Among these two value, which is the least cell? This is the least cell, because 9 is greater than 2. Now just compare the demand and supply. Which one is lesser value? Demand is lesser value. Just write 200, 0, remaining 300. So this column got 0, no? Just delete this column. Now we have only 2 rows and 2 columns. Again you have to find out row difference and column difference. For this 5 and 6, difference 1. For this row 3, 3, nil. And for this column 3, 6, 3 difference. For this column 3, 5, 2 is the difference. Among these values, these penalties, which is the highest value? 3. it occurs in second column. Among the two value, which one is least? This is the least value. Select this cell, and here we have only 50 but supply 300. Which is the less value? Demand is lesser value than supply. Just put 50 here, remaining 250. Here you got 0. Just cancel this column. Now you have only two values. Among these two values, find out the least value. 3 is the least value. Select this cell and just see, demand 400, supply only 250. Just allocate 250 here. Here you will get 0. Here you will get 150. 0, no, cancel this row. Now you have only one cell. While you have last cell, you will have equal value. Both demand and supply will be equal always. Why? Because it is a balanced transportation problem. Both demand and supply is equal, no? So the entire supply and entire demand is exhausted. Now you can find out the total transportation cost with the allocated cell. 300 into 1. Just multiply with the product. Into 1, 250 into 2 plus 150 into 5 plus 50 into 3 plus 250 into 3 plus 200 into 2. The solution is 2850. The total cost of the solution is obtained by adding the product of cost of transportation. Thank you.